to Charlotte Takes Tijuana. We're leaving LA now. On the map, it takes about almost 3 hours to our Airbnb, which we will show you later. It's gonna be so cute. So the reason why we're going to Tijuana is it's our anniversary, but we only had 2 or 3 days where we could spare to enjoy, and we were like, why not Tijuana? It's about 10:20 in the morning right now. Josh is driving, and we'll see how this goes. It's quite busy. We're taking the route that our Airbnb host recommended. We're taking the tollway and we're keeping the receipt, and the host told us to keep the receipt because it will be a good, if any accident happens on this toll. We were just greeted by our Airbnb host. I'm gonna show you a quick look of where we'll be staying in this weekend. So this is our little room. Beautiful painting. A little small bathroom. The shower is in the other house, which we will show you later. And look at this patio. This leads to the beach, which we will for sure enjoy. Our Airbnb host gave us good recommendations for the restaurant and places to check out, so we'll probably go there tonight and tomorrow. So we're here at Las Buisas. It was recommended by our Airbnb host. This is actually Lobster Village. I never knew. So there's this strip of all sorts of seafood places. Honestly, as soon as I walked out of the car, it smelled like seafood, like boiled lobster or boiled shrimp. So I'm so excited to eat. Okay, I'm just gonna try this sauce. And that's pretty smoky. That's spicy. If it's spicy for a Korean, it's quite spicy. And then some pico.
Does it taste any different from LA?
No. It's a little bit more spicy though, because it has jalapeno. Actually, a lot more spicy. Actually, that's not jalapeno. That's a serrano pepper. What is that? We got the lobster and shrimp.
Okay.
And then for the lobster, do we choose whether it's steamed or...
Steamed?
Oh, can we do the fried grill? Okay. Yeah. And then we'll get the garlic crab like you recommended.
Okay.
Yeah, would that be enough for two people?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's good for two people.
Yeah.
Okay.
You might order more if you get hungry.
Thanks. No worries. Yeah, it's put in the middle and extra plate on the side.
Yeah.
Rice and beans, flour.
Ah, oh yes, yes, yes. Thank you, gracias. Soon as you enter this area, in order to get to this restaurant, we had to like kind of ignore eight, I don't know, ushers. I think they're saying parking spot, but I think if you park with them, you have to go to their restaurant. We knew exactly where we wanted to go, and we met a parking usher right in front of this restaurant, and he found a perfect spot for us.
The La Margarita is muy bien, muy rico, very strong. It's it honestly tastes like a snack drink. It's kind of like a candy. You know, when you're in Mexico of any kind, you gotta try their margarita, and so far it's so good, but we'll see what the damage does.
So we got a little special from the house. Thank you. It's a fish soup. So this looks like cilantro, maybe like tomato base. I already know I'm gonna like it. It's good. It's like not so such strong tomato base, a bit mild in a way. Even the cilantro, I thought it would be like really strong cilantro flavor, but actually not like just good amount. I'm gonna try. It's like perfect hangover cure. Delicious, a little bit of garlic. Nice though. Thanks. Gracias. So that's the lobster with shrimp. It's fried, grilled with butter. And there's some extra butter here. And then this is the garlic crabs. And of course, Mexican rice and beans. And then,
famous tortillas.
Wow. Well, this is a lot. Yum.
So we start.
I think we're set. What should we start with? I'm not good at
a Korean not knowing how to crack shellfish, that's unheard of.
So here I have some beans, Spanish rice, which I'm gonna add a little bit of this salsa. Some salad, tortilla that's like steaming hot. I could like put some of this in there, some of the rice, and eat it like this. Butter grilled shrimp. Honestly, shrimp is my favorite. It's seasoned perfectly. Not too saucy. You can still taste the taste of the shrimp, which is the main flavor. It's just delicious. Even the garlic crab, the garlic flavor doesn't overpower the flavor of the crab. I think that's the thing about seafood. Nothing is more delicious than the seafood flavor itself. You'd never want to overpower that original flavor. That's what I love. Dunk, 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 dunk. Okay, that's too much. I still think shrimp is better. Is that a little lobster blasphemy? So be it.
You know, they say, Hangu salam anichi, you know, that's what they tell me. But I say, a true Korean is judged by how much they can eat. That's a real Korean. And I have proved myself time and time again that I am more Korean than most Hangul saram. Even though my Korean is terrible, I can eat the hell out of any seafood and food in Korea. Tortilla, put some rice, mix it in with the beans. There's a little bit of a Texas style joint. These are great tortillas, by the way.
Throw really good tortillas.
Smear it on. See that? It's beautiful. Throw the crab and the lobster on there.
Dang, that's a fancy.
Taco.
That's a really fancy taco.
With some pico, gotta have a little bit of vegetables, can't have that go wrong. A little bit of salsa.
Sprinkle some lime.
And put a little bit of bang, fold it over.
With the hat and the dance, you look really drunk. Okay, that was pretty pathetic of me. I couldn't eat that much. I blame the In-N-Out Well Done fries that I had before without the animal style cheese. Because my husband got the wrong order. But anyways, it was so delicious. I'm just enjoying it. It's a vibe. It's a vibe. I know that's just like such a millennial way of putting things, describing things, but it's a vibe. I love that there's music here. It keeps changing. You can eat the food, you can watch the kids running around. You get live music changing every minute. And just the sun.
We asked her, the waiter, for a recommendation of restaurants. So he gave us a little note. So we'll probably check out these places tomorrow. But this is actually the best way to learn about what the locals really eat, rather than just depending on Yelp or internet.
So we're here at Puerto Nuevo Gallery. What's your name?
Jesus.
Eso. Hey, Jesus. Jesus. Like Jesus. Yeah.
We use wax for my glue. This is bead wax and tree wax.
Oh, can I touch it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. I put on paper like this.
Mm-hmm.
And I just use my just brush and break. Piece. Can do the shadow movements. You put light. You can see the photo is a little bit.
You do it
color,
so.
And I put more bright the colors.
What is this art like style called?
Straw art.
Straw art.
Colored straw.
Art of straw.
Colored.
A colored straw.
Colored straw, yes.
Sorry.
It's an Aztec technique.
Oh. Yes. Aztec technique.
Yes.
Wow. Is this the Last Supper?
Mm-hmm.
I like the Frida Kahlo. That one. I like that one. Yeah. It's beautiful. How many years did you have you been doing creating this art?
I'm new working here.
Really?
Like 2 years. My boss there, they work all his life here.
Wow.
And this gallery here in Puerto Nuevo is around 17 years.
17 oh, years, 17 wow. Years. Wait, so in 2 years, you learned how to do this in 2 years?
Yes.
Wow, are you an artist before?
No, I was a bartender.
What? That's wow. Crazy.
I met my boss in at the gym in Rosarito, and he invited me to work here.
Really, just one day? And you're like, okay, I'll try it out.
Yeah.
But you like, it's so much attention to detail. Is.
Yes.
Oh.
Well, just I just need my nails for right there.
Oh.
Like this size.
Mm. Oh wow.
First years.
Mm-hmm.
And then I made the bigger ones.
Mm-hmm.
And my last and big piece is the big hummingbird.
Oh, the bird, hummingbird? Yes. Oh, it's beautiful.
Right now, the day of the dead.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Just looking around. That one's beautiful. So, this is Cafe de Oya. Smells like regular coffee with a little bit of hint of cinnamon. It's like coffee and sujeongwa, you know, the Korean cinnamon drink. It's mixed together. And sweet, a little bit of honey. Is it dark brown sugar? Or oh, it's delicious. It's
exactly in Chiapas, maybe Yucatan, Veracruz, they
Yucatan?
Don't know sugar, regular sugar. And they use natural sugar cane.
Oh. Mmm. Basta. Ganzambe?
Ready?
Okay. This fire is sugar cane liquor.
Wow. Woo.
Cinnamon.
Woo! Wow.
Okay. The drink is espresso. Un poco de canela. And tequila on fire.
Coca.
Okay. And finally, it's a cream of chocolate.
It's beautiful.
Yes, at least.
You're like, get your own.
make it at two. A cold and a hot.
Oh, I thought it would be like really sweet.
No, it's perfect.
It's not, yeah.
No,
it's
perfect.
Mm-hmm.
What's it taste like?
Tastes like everything good, like chocolate, milk, Kahlua, coffee, a little bit of, yeah, cinnamon, everything, but like really balanced well. And a little bit of like toasted flavor. Delicious.
Pretty little spot.
Spending our anniversary in Tijuana, or Rosarito.
But this is Puerto Nuevo.
Yeah, very nice people, extremely nice. It's nice. You know, it's just we're having some drinks, having some coffee.
Yeah, a bit touristy, know. But still
it's a little
nice.
Touristy. But sometimes we gotta do touristy things to enjoy the other stuff. So, you know, it's still great.
Enjoyed our time in Puerto Nuevo, but it's our first night. We're gonna take it easy and chill by the beach, actually. And look at this. This is the sound that we're gonna fall asleep to. So it's Tijuana day 2 or Rosarito day 2. So this morning we went downstairs and we walked this morning beach. It's a little chilly. It was really nice falling asleep to the sound of the waves. It's pretty therapeutic. So we're gonna go downtown Tijuana and check out Caesar's, from which the original Caesar salad name comes from. I'll take you with me. We are in Avenue Revolution. At least we're approaching it. Tijuana by Samsung, of course. Here at Caesar's, where Caesar salad was invented or created. So, let's try how good the Caesar salad is. It looks like a tapenade.
Oh, yeah, look
at that. Look at that. Alright, we'll play with the food, people. It's just baguette with tapenade, olives.
So, I'm starting off the morning with a cafe martini. And don't judge me. It's our anniversary, so I can do whatever I want. I'm not a raging alcoholic, I don't think. But so I got the cafe because, you know, I need coffee. It's vodka, Coco Obscuro espresso, right? And it's 1.15. And then obviously that's pesos. So translated right now, we're spending 115 Mexican peso. It's about $5.77. That's freaking fantastic.
Speaking of drinks, this place is where like a lot of Hollywood stars came to drink during the Prohibition. I guess they crossed the border during that time to have a party. Very Gatsby. Yeah.
And here's the gentleman with my amazing cafe, the martini.
The Caesar ensalada. Mm-hmm. Wait, I'll add the anchovies. Mm-hmm. We'll get the tortilla soup. The beef Wellington. Yeah.
Thank you so
much. Yes.
Gracias.
Gracias.
I want to explain why I'm all brown all the time, because I feel like your viewers might not realize it, but brown is my favorite color, but also because it's the most...
That's khaki.
Khaki, whatever. It's the most comfortable color to wear when you travel. I have found that any other color brings a different type of vibe, but if you wear brown and you go this whole, like, this
military
whole,
camouflage
not military,
look.
Not military. Safari kind of look. People are super comfortable with you and trust you for some reason. And I've always found this to be just a relaxing thing. And there's a less intimidation than wearing blue, red, orange, or whatever color, black and stuff. So that's what you're wondering. Like, this guy looks like he's on a safari. It's because I have my reasons. Anyways, let's try this beautiful martini. Dang. That's like drinking candy.
I'm gonna say, here's to looking at you, kid. For real. It already smells so good before. Mm. Mm. this every night, but it will become a problem. Pasta. So Josh put the bread away from me so I wouldn't eat it all.
That's how last time it happened. We had all that lobster and she didn't want to eat it last night. This is nice.
This is what it must have looked like back then when movie stars drove here to get a drink or a party. Frothy, gives a very complex texture, and it's like not that salty. I mean, just enough salt, just enough amount of salt. Never had anyone make me salad with this amount of effort and suave and finesse. So this is definitely an experience.
We got ourselves a tortilla soup here, which is fantastic. Maybe this is not tortilla soup? I don't know what this is.
Oh, is it French onion soup?
It's like French onion soup.
Maybe they gave us this by mistake. It's okay. We'll still eat it.
Yeah.
Are you a dunker or are you like a... I'm a dunker.
I'm a pourer, but it's okay.
Yeah, okay. I thought Gordon Ramsay created beef Wellington. Pink inside. It's kind of a big piece. Very tender meat. Needs a little bit of salt, but it's delicious. Prenza de manzana, pastel de elote. Chocolate mousse, crepe suzette, flan. I think I'm just gonna stick to my cappuccino. It's a cappuccino. I feel like I have to like behave so well here. I'm like, such a nice place.
The story of how it got made is so interesting. You got the original recipe as well as a little biography. They gave it to me from the restaurant. So yeah, I'm gonna do a separate video about the whole experience and the story behind the original Caesar salad.
I forgot to film this one. Yeah, we're just having a good time enjoying our meal. Cheers.
You got us, but you gave us a good deal.
Oh, super good deal. Amiga.
Gracias.
You walk around, when you realize you get something real, you might come back and get the other pendant.
Mexico Curios. Mexico Curios.
We are the oldest in the city.
Oldest in the city?
My boss owned this shop for almost 70 years.
70 years? One spot? One Same location?
Spot, yeah.
Wow, good business, huh?
Well, more for the tourists. I mean.
More for tourists? Okay. Oh.
Good business years ago.
Good business years ago? Oh, yes. Now not so much?
Not so much.
Oh. See. Well, I hope it gets better.
Yeah, it's global crisis.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Actually, this is my first malachite. I always wanted a malachite, but I never got it. And this is, I get it in Mexico, or Tijuana. Gracias! Found something. Look! Oh my god. Nacho Libre.
Summer vibe drink, fantastic.
Pasadita, and this is a place where our waiter from the lobster restaurant recommended. So let's try it. Ooh, pretty big, the tacos. It's not like LA street tacos where it's this big. It's big and full. Okay, I don't know which one is which, but we ordered
Cabeza,
asada, adobada. What's adobada?
I have no idea.
Ah, gracias. Ooh. Let's do this. Mm-hmm. is. It's like so much, it's like half the thickness of like just normal tacos that I'm used to. And then, it has like a nutty smell to the tortilla. Super juicy. It has a nice amount of kick that I like. Even the lime is like super, even just the lime is like so fresh here.
Pepper right here is dangerous, yo. Hot pepper.
When you're eating a taco, you have to like eat it as you're making love to it. Like it's like a makeup session. I would say this two taco this size is like equivalent of 3.5 tacos of like LA street taco. Like the amount.
Yeah.
That's enough mukbang for today. And tomorrow is our last day. We're not sure what we're gonna do tomorrow, but we'll see. Chaka ranchera and quail egg, and then you get machaca and eggs.
Yes.
Is this leche?
Si.
Oh, gracias. I like mine with lots of cream, actually. Nachos, spicy salsa, and coffee. What can go wrong? Oh, this is a lot.
Like in 40 minutes.
Try the spicy
sauce.
Oh, it's bad eating quail. It's so small. I knew I was one of like the chilaquiles. It's like my favorite.
You want to trade? And this is it.
That's this dough smell that I like.
It's very thin.
Oh, shit. So soft. That was the best flour tortilla I've ever had in my life.
Yes, yay. Yes.
You too.
Yes, you too. Rosarito, yay. And we are going to head back home. It's 11:30 now. Hopefully traffic isn't so bad on a Sunday. Yeah. Hopefully it doesn't take hours to cross the border. So we'll find out when we go back. There's a lot of salespeople coming to your car to sell all sorts of stuff: potato chips, churros, religious, I don't know, statues, tarps, Raiders towels. At one point, we even saw tiny two puppies, and one of it was a pug. The puppies were so cute; they're probably like 4 weeks old. That we're trying to sell us stuff. He said it's gonna take 3 hours, but we'll see. Hopefully it doesn't take that long. While waiting to cross the border, we saw puppy, blankets, bracelets, hats, San Diego Padre, a jersey, all sorts of food, ice cream, fries, burritos, molitas, fried plantains, and a window wiping service. But now, at the same time, what is it?
Dent removal.
Dent removal in your car. We saw a person with an Audi getting her dent removed in her bumper.
I guess that's what he's doing.
Yeah. This is so exciting. Sandals. And there's sandals, like leather cowboy goods, hats. Cowboy hats, belts, leather belts, Hello Kitty, stuff, aprons. You know, but in a way, I'm kind of thankful and I appreciate this because it makes the wait not boring at all. It's, you know, I can kind of take a look at all the services that they, or services or goods that they sell here. Oh, and there's also performance. Yes, we forgot about that. There's a performance with like a traditional outfit on with a pipe. Yeah. So this is all on the highway. You have pots, blankets, $2.25. So that took about 2.5 hours on a Sunday morning, afternoon. That's it for Tijuana. Everyone we interacted with was so sweet and very generous and kind. Yeah, we're definitely going to be back to explore more, experience more, and learn more. And yeah, so that's it for today.
Doggy.
So thank you, Tijuana, for a good time, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye.